Steinbeck. That's right. Good Lord. I'm telling you, it's a full moon night. I started to say Sanchez, and I knew that wasn't right, and then your name totally escaped me. First down, or second down, and 8 from the 30-yard line, and the handoff. No, Perez going to keep himself out across the 30. Breaks free. 50, 45, 40. Foot race 30 to the 20. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Cougars. No flags anywhere. College Station has tied it up. So Marquez Perez ties it up on one big carry with the extra point pending. Bauer Sox Allen to add the critical extra point out of the hold of Jacob Blaha. Good snap and hold. The kick is blocked. And this can be returned. Picked up, coming back the other way. 25, 30. To the 40. To the 50. To the 40. It's a foot race for 2 points. To the 20. Breaking a tackle. 10, 5. I don't think he got in. The official wasn't there. No indication yet. Nope, he didn't get it. I think it was the right call. Picking it up was Phillip Lively and taking it back the other way. They're going to talk about it. Lively beat the officials back. I don't think he got it in. They're talking it over. Now they're going to give it to him. And now the College Station side is livid. What a turn of events. The extra point attempt was blocked. Then scooping it up at the 25-yard line, it was a foot race. We're checking the replay here. You're seeing it as well. Judge for yourself. The official was 10 yards trailing the play. Well, from that angle, it looks like he made it. That was close. Phillip Lively returns a blocked extra point attempt, 75 yards, to put Cal Allen on top, 24-22. And boy, Coach Huff is hot on the sideline. I think what bothers him was that they initially said no and then changed the call. Yeah, Chris pointed out a good point. There was 2 points that were taken away from Cal Allen earlier, I think, that this one, if there's any benefit of the doubt going to be given, it's probably going to be given to Cal Allen. When I saw it live, I didn't think he got it in. I thought the knees or the foot went out before the ball hit the pylon. But watching the replay, again, the camera was a long ways away. You'll have to go back and judge for yourself at the conclusion of the live broadcast. But in any event, it doesn't matter. It's 2 points for Cal Allen. And they get the lead back 24-22. What a swing. College Station scores on a touchdown scamper by Perez. The extra point attempt is blocked and returned 75 yards by Phillip Lively for 2 points for College Station, or for Cal Allen. The Wildcats now nursing a 2-point lead with 11:48 to go. And Cal Allen will get the football back. Been a crazy football game. And the kickoff sailing over to the far sideline. Going to be returned up to 5 to the 10. To the 15, up to the 20, and knocked out of bounds there at the 22-yard line. Good return from Austin Weishart, pushed out of bounds by Dylan Carnes, I believe. And Cal Allen will take over first down and 10, moving right to left from the 22-yard line. Merle Bertrand, Chris Standback here. Chris Norris back in the studios, making sure that we're staying on the air now after the earlier internet issues. .11:42 left. In a game like this, I better say regulation time. I don't think we're quite done with this one yet. Here we go. Gage Lamb, 6'1", 200-pound senior quarterback. He's had a couple of runs tonight. Looking for another one. Cuts it up and dives into the line. Maybe gets out to the 23-yard line. A short pickup there of a yard or so before he's wrapped up and knocked down by the Cougar defense. Gain of a yard for Lamb, second down and 9 from the 23. Now more of a slot T look here. The close cousin of the wing T, they hand it to the up back. And diving into the line and knocked down there at the 24-yard line. I believe that was Brown on the carry. It was. Kind of playing whack-a-mole. You got to guess which one of the running backs has a football when they come out in a formation like that. If I had to guess, I'd say A.J. Brown. He is definitely the workhorse for Cal Allen, who are now facing a third down and 8 from the 24-yard line. Big play in this game with 10:25 to go in regulation time. Third and 8 from the 24. Lamb up under center. Play action. Looking downfield. Under pressure. Rolling to his right. He's sacked. Sack for a loss back at the 12-yard line. Crashing in from the backside with Dylan Carnes. Just got a shoelace, but it was enough to trip up Lamb and knock him down. And now Lamb will go back in punt formation. College Station figures to get pretty good field position. Peterson back to receive the kick. He's standing at about his own 48-yard line. Actually standing in midfield. They've had a fake punt tonight. I wouldn't expect them to do it here, this deep in their own territory. And Lamb, low kick, almost blocked, takes a pretty good roll, and whistles blow. Hold everything, flag down. Looks like procedure going to be the call against Cal Allen. We'll push him back 5 more yards. That is the call, false start. So the Wildcats inside the 10-yard line now, kind of moving into danger zone. Lamb will field the snap in the end zone. And Peterson will move up into Cal Allen territory awaiting the punt. Pressure came from the left side last time. Better job of protection this time. Kind of a low line drive kick. Peterson fields that on the dead run, 42-40. To the 35, makes the first man miss. To the outside, gets a block, 30. To the 25, to the 20, to the 15, cuts it back, spins inside of the 10, to the 5, touchdown, College Station. 47 yards for Eric Peterson, and College Station back on top. Got a good block, bouncer to the outside, broke a tackle, spun inside. And now it looks like College Station will try to go for 2 as everybody's chasing points here now. They're up by 4. They'd like to get themselves a 6-point lead with 9:12 to go. Four minutes to go, third quarter, still 21-14. Alito on top of Poteet. Cougars are going for 2. No surprise here. The 2-point conversion attempt. Marquez Perez in the shotgun. Trips wide right. Now a man coming in motion right to left. Reverses back to the right. Perez to his right. Cuts it up. Breaks free. Dives. Throws across the goal line. And the 2-point conversion is good. So 9:12 to go in regulation time. And you better say regulation time now because we got kind of a conventional score. 30-24. After the 42-yard punt return by Eric Peterson. And we've got a heck of a ball game. Well, it figures in the playoffs. Cal Allen was giving up 6.6 points per game, and Cal Station was giving up 13.5 points per game. We're already up to 30-24, some of that coming from special teams, obviously. But the offense is having the upper hand. Maybe that's not a surprise. College Station's offense is averaging 47.4 points per game and 440.8 yards per game, while Cal Allen's was averaging 38.9 points per game and 367 yards per game. So defense may win championships, but offense has the upper hand here tonight so far. Kickoff from the 40-yard line, pounded. This one is going to go into and out of the end zone. Good job there by Ryan Bowersox, a senior. So 9:12 to go, and Cal Allen trailing once again tonight. They've been to this game 11 times, their only trip to the state finals in 2005. And in that game, they knocked off Brenham in 2005 in their only state championship. So the Wildcats have been the bridesmaid a couple of times, would much rather get all the way there tonight. Cal Station standing in the way. They've got a six-point lead to the Cougars. The Wildcats have the football moving right to left. First down and 10 at the 25-yard line. Lamb handoff. And Brown breaking tackles out to the 31-yard line. He strikes me as the kind of back that gets stronger as the night wears on. Just a sophomore. I'm sure Coach Dadaher very pleased to have him for two more years. Brown, 1,456 yards and 18 touchdowns coming into tonight. Picked up six on that carry. Second down and four from the 31. Lamb gives it to him. Left side, dives near the first down marker. Will depend on the spot, but I think he got it. Good hard running before being knocked down there by Kiki Anderson. So the Wildcats move the chains. First down and 10 from the 35-yard line with 8:16 to go. The clock moving. Season on the line. State championship berth at stake. And Lamb's going to keep it himself. Cuts it up at the 40. Into the secondary to the 45. Stays on his feet to the 50, 45, 40. To the 35-foot race. To the 25. Cuts it back to the inside. Breaks a tackle. And down inside the 10. Still digging for more. Down to the 6-yard line. What a run by Gage Lamb. Breaking tackles. Yards, first down and goal for the Cal Allen Wildcats from the College Station 7. First and goal for Cal Allen. Lamb up under center. Give it to Brown. Dives into the line inside the 5, and Pyle drives it down to about the 3, maybe the 4, second to go from there. Plenty of time left, even if the Wildcats do punch it in. Coming up in the 7-minute mark, which is coming up right now. 7 minutes to go in regulation time. 30-24, Cal Station on top. Cal Allen driving for the lead. Second to go from the 4. Place is getting loud. And a timeout. Coach Danaher saw something he didn't like and called a timeout with 6:44 to go. That's the first timeout taken by either squad here in the second half. And it comes with 6:44 left in regulation time. Merle Bertrand here along with Chris Standback. Chris Norris back at the studios, making sure that we're staying on the air, looking and sounding as good as we possibly can. After the timeout, second down and goal from the 5. Second and goal from just inside the 5-yard line. Lamb up under center. He's going to keep it himself. He gets towards the end zone. Did he get it in? Touchdown. Touchdown, Cal Allen. Nice misdirection on the fake handoff. And then Lamb just muscled it in for what I believe is his third touchdown of the night. And we're tied at 30 with 6:38 to go. Critical extra point attempt coming. Low snap. The kick is up. And he knocked it through. Gonzalez knocked it through. Won't win any style points. And give an assist there to Colton Duff because that snap looked a little bit low. But the sophomore has been clutch tonight. And with 6:38 to go in regulation time in a back and forth football game, it's now 31-30. Cal Allen back in top. To go. You still got time to grab yourself a sandwich. I think we're going to have a good finish on this one. This might be one of those who has the football last wins kind of games. Kind of reminiscent of the old San Antonio Gunslingers that used to play. Are the Gunslingers here? No, that was the Houston. San Antonio's USFL team. I can't remember what their name was. Used to play here. Boy, I'm really dating myself now when I'm talking USFL football. Kickoff coming from the 40-yard line, squibbed on the ground, and it goes out of bounds. That's probably not what Coach Kent Danaher wanted. But that will give College Station pretty good field position with 6:38 to go. We'll see what they wind up doing here. It was the Gunslingers. I had to look it up. It was bugging me. It was the San Antonio Gunslingers. I thought it was. Now I can't remember what Houston's franchise was. I remember Jim Kelly was their quarterback. In more important issues, under a minute to go in the third quarter, 24-14. Alito has now taken a 10-point lead with a field goal in the third quarter over Poteet. So looking like they'll take that 10-point lead into the fourth quarter. The winner of that one gets the winner of this one. In the state championship game, here comes College Station. Now left to right, first down, 10 to the 30-yard line. A reverse, double reverse, trying to turn the corner, looking for running room, gets it up to the 30, and drug down there at about the 34-yard line. Kind of an awkward tackle. And it wound up being Eric Peterson on the double reverse. Kind of got the corner turned to pick up about 3 yards. Second down and 7 from the 33. Perez to his left. Busts a tackle to the 35-yard line, but can't get by the second guy. He's going to be knocked down there at the 38. Bring up a critical third down and short. Big, big play coming up here. Third down and 3 from the 37. 4 receivers to the near side. Empty back set for Marquez Perez. 1 receiver wide left. Quarterback draw up the middle. Tripped up. Tripped up as he approached the line, and he did not pick up the first down. Nice job by Kenisi Leomidi. 6'4", 275-pound junior got in there and wrapped him up and stopped him about a yard and a half shy. And they're going to go for it. Play of the game right here. 5 minutes to go, fourth down and two for College Station. Perez, same play, left side. And this time he does get it up for the first down. Needed two, got three. And the fans in purple across the way are breathing a sigh of relief. I think Coach Steve Huff realized that if he punted away, they might not get the football back with under 5 minutes to go. And it pays off. First down and 10 at the 41-yard line for College Station. Moving left to right. Just need a field goal. They don't need the whole six. Perez rolls to his right, dumps it off underneath. Sliding catch made at the 46-yard line. That'll be good for about 5 yards. That pass hauled in by Braden Shearhart. Ryan Bowersox, a senior kicker, has a long now of 40. His team trailing it by one with 4:10 to go. Handoff up the middle. Looking for running room. Dives out to the 50-yard line, very near the first down marker. And that was Dada Anderson, a junior running back. Boy, a lot of juniors on this College Station team for a third-year program. Would not at all be surprised to see them back at this level next year. They've already gone for it on fourth down once. They'd probably go for it again if they need to. They don't want to have to try. Third down on a foot from the 50-yard stripe. Quarterback's going to keep it and going to depend on the spot. Doesn't look like he got it from where the line judge is coming in, but the official on the far side is about a foot down the field. Going to bring up a fourth down, it looks like. Now they're going to stop and measure. From here, he doesn't have it. Looks like he's about 6 inches shy. Right on the 50-yard line with 3:21 to go. Into the third quarter, 24-14. Alito on top of Poteet. You can see for yourself, I don't think he got it. Nope. He's a good foot shy. Well, they've converted once on fourth down. They've got to do it again. The season's on the line for College Station. If Cal Allen gets a stop here, they might be able to start celebrating, but still plenty of time left, 3:21 to go. College Station with three timeouts. I said it was the play of the game a moment ago when it was. Now it's the play of the game here with 3:21 to go. Fourth down on the foot. From the 50-yard stripe. Trying to get the clocks to wind. There we go. Fourth down and a foot. Perez in the shotgun. Trips wide left one here to the near side. And now we're going to get a timeout called by Cal Allen. That's our second. They have one timeout remaining. Mark that down if College Station does happen to take the lead here. Cal Allen will be short on timeouts. They just have one left with 3:16 to go. Interesting. It has been a back-and-forth football game tonight. Merle Bertrand, Chris Stanbeck here. Happy to have you folks aboard. Tuned in all across the country on NFHS. Here we go, fourth down and a foot from the 50-yard stripe. Same formation, trips wide left, one on the near side. Wildcats adjust their defense. Yeah, boy, I don't know. It depends on which official they go by. Perez crashed across the line but was knocked backwards. It's going to depend on forward progress. I don't think he got it. They're going to have to measure again. He was knocked backwards. His body was across the line, but the part of the body with the football didn't advance very far. College Station didn't like the call. Boy, there have been some serious spotting questions tonight. You'll be able to tell by the reaction here in just a second. Nope, didn't get it. So two tries to pick up a yard, and the Cougars can't do it. Kyle Allen stops them with 3:11 to go. Cougars with three timeouts remaining. So advantage certainly Kyle Allen, but the game isn't over yet. So Gage Lamb will lead him out. First down and 10 at the 50-yard line. They come out in the wing tee. Handoff, A.J. Brown. He just keeps on getting stronger. Rugby piling it forward down to the 41-yard line. Still driving the pile forward, and he's got the first down, but they're going to say his forward progress was stopped. So they gave him 8 yards on the carry, second down and two from the 42. Inside of 3 minutes. College Station will have to use their timeouts here shortly. Seven-six College Station after one. 16-12 College Station at the half. 22-16 Cal Allen at the end of three. It's now 31-30 Cal Allen with the football. Second down or two at the Cougar 42-yard line. And that's going to be a good play. First down on the kind of a counter play to Zach Hawkins. They picked the inside handoff to Brown. And they give it to Hawkins coming in from the backside off the left tackle. Good for a first down. And Cal Station has to burn their first timeout. They have two remaining with 2:16 to go. See if I can step you through the scoring real quick. Marquez Perez, a 3-yard touchdown run to put College Station on top 6-0. And then 7-0 after the extra point. Cal Allen had a 60-yard touchdown run from Lamb. But the extra point was no good, 7-6. A field goal. Made it 10-6 in favor of College Station. Then a 2-yard rushing touchdown for Cal Allen put them up 12-10. Missed the 2-point conversion. A touchdown from Marquez Perez, 12-yard pass to Eric Peterson. The 2-point conversion attempt failed to make it 16-12. And that's how we went to halftime. In the third quarter, Gage Lamb, a 35-yard rushing touchdown to make it 18-16. The extra point was good to make it 19-16. Stayed that way until a field goal made it 22-16 for Cal Allen. Here we go back to the action. First down and 10 from the 37-yard line. Hand off to Brown. Picks his way inside the 35 down to the 31-yard line to pick up 7 yards, second down and three. Perez, a 72-yard touchdown run to make it 22-22. The extra point attempt was blocked and returned 75 yards to make it 24-22, Cal Allen. Then coming back the other way, Peterson, a 40-yard rushing touchdown to make it 28-24, College Station. The 2-point conversion attempt was good to make it 30-24. But then later on in the football game, Cal Allen. Colton Duff, a 5-yard rushing touchdown to make it 30-all. The point attempt was good, and that's where we stand, 31-30 with 2:06 to go. In regulation time, it's second down and about four for Cal Allen from the College Station 31-yard line. What a football game tonight here at the Alamo Dome. Seven minutes to go, it looks like. Alito is driving again inside the Poteet 20-yard line. They're already up by 10. That would just about do it. If the Bearcats can push that one across, they're up 24-14. Winner of that one gets the winner of this one. Second down and four from the 31-yard line. Lamb up under center. Hand off to Brown. And stacked up as he approached the 30-yard line. That's about it. Maybe a yard pickup. Good job there gang tackling there by the College Station defense. And College Station takes their third and final timeout with 1:55 to go. So it's basically get a stop here for College Station or Cal Allen can run out the clock now. And if you're Coach Danaher and you don't pick it up and you're facing a fourth down, what do you do? I think you'd probably go for it and let your defense, but you only need to give up a field goal to lose a football game. So if you're Cal Allen, obviously you just want to pick up the first down here and then start taking an E. College Station, your season rides on this play. It's third down and three from the College Station 30-yard line with 2:03 to go in regulation time. Cal Allen football up by one. Here we go. Game on the line. Third and three from the 30. Lamb under center. Fumble. Ball's on the carpet. And College Station has it at the 35-yard line. Coming up with the football is Anthony Flores. It was poked away as Lamb tried to take it around the right side. And in there getting a hand on it was Kiki Anderson. He was on the ground and he reached up and swatted the ball away from Lamb as Lamb turned the corner. Flores fell on it. 1:58 to go. College Station football from their own 35-yard line needing a field goal for the lead. What a turn of events. Marquez Perez leads him out. The junior quarterback dropping back, looking downfield, buys plenty of time. Now scrambling left, got running room to the 40 to the outside, got the first down and out of bounds to the 47-yard line. Only took nine ticks off the clock, moved the ball 12 yards and a first down. This game has had more plot twists than the best novel out there. First and 10 from the 47-yard line. Oh, that should have been procedure. Wasn't called. Perez fires left side. Got a receiver open. Incomplete. Tried to swing it out to Dada Anderson. The College Station, it may have been Anderson, in fact, moved early, but the officials didn't catch it. Second down and 10 from the 47. Stops the clock with 1:43 to go. Bauer Sox as long as 40, but we're in a dome. Trips here to the near side. And whistles blow, and this might be a formation thing. Procedure the call. I didn't see anybody move, but they may not have had enough guys lined up in the line of scrimmage. I couldn't hear what the officials said, but both officials threw the flag instantly. So that pushes the Cougars back 5 yards, makes it second and 15 from the 42. Four receivers now here to the near side. One split wide left, empty back set for Perez. Dropping back, pincer movement coming, scrambles for it, and gets back to the 45, and that's it before he's drugged down from behind. It's going to bring up a third down. Trying to see who made that stop. I can't get a good look at the number. Kenise Liamati, I believe, on the stop. They're going for it quickly. Perez fires it to the near side. Dyer, catch made at the 46-yard line, but a yard shy of the first down. Jalen Campbell hauls it in, but he's a yard or two shy, And it's fourth down with 1:15 to go. And here's your ball game right here for College Station. Fourth down and two from the 45. Wildcats fans shouting defense. Fans of both sides on their feet. Trips wide left, one to the near side. Fourth and two with the season on the line, and we're going to get a timeout called by College Station, or check that by Cal Allen. They'll take their third and final timeout with 75 ticks on the clock. What a game here tonight at the Alamo Dome. The 5A Division II state semifinal between Corpus Christi, Cal Allen, and College Station. What a storied program in this game for an 11th time. The other making just their third year of varsity play already in the state semifinal game. Six minutes to go up at Ford Field up in Frisco, 31-14 now. Aledo has pulled away, and they look like they're closing in as they look to shut out Poteet and meet the winner of this one. And what will be the 5A Division II state championship game next weekend up in Dallas? Who's it going to be? We're 75 seconds away from finding out. Fourth and two for College Station at the Cal Allen 45-yard line. Trips wide left, one receiver near side. Anson in the backfield, lined up behind Marquez Perez. Perez to his right, tripped up, doesn't get it. I don't think he got it. Didn't get it, not even close, about a yard and a half shy. That's a turnover on downs, and Cal Allen is going to advance to the state championship game, barring a turnover. Great pursuit from the backside. I was trying to catch the replay to see who it was. They're hugging on somebody. It looked like it may have been big number 70. If it was number 70, that was Justice Escobar on the stop. It is first and 10, Cal Allen at their own 45-yard line with 1:07 to go. No timeouts remaining for the Cougars. So if you're College Station, if you're Cal Allen, you just want to make clean snaps here. Two backs lined up behind Lamb as a safety valve. The victory formation here for Cal Allen. Lamb takes a snap, takes a